As we've been telling you in our weather forecasts, we are in for a hot and muggy week. So what are the dangers of this type of weather, and how do you know if you're dehydrated? Alex Berk, MD with Emergency Medicine at Adventist Health Castle, joins us now with details. Good morning and welcome.
Good morning.
So first of all, what are the dangers of doing highly physical activities in this type of weather? And can you define physical activities? What if you just went for a walk for 5 minutes across the street?
Sure. Any activity that honestly makes you sweat is going to be exertional activity. The reason why we sweat, though, is because a sheen of water comes onto our body, and then as it evaporates, it actually cools us down. Now, in this hot, muggy, humid environment, that evaporative loss doesn't really happen, and so you kind of lose that cooling effect. Mm-hmm. And that actually creates even more problems, because then the water is sitting on your skin. It actually makes you trap in even more heat, so you sweat even more. And that actually creates this weird situation where you have very wet skin on the outside, but are dehydrated on the inside.
So how else do you know if you're dehydrated?
Well, the first signs are going to be dry mouth, dry lips, and tongue. If you really don't do anything about it, that can then progress on to having a rapid heartbeat. People can have very dark urine or even no urine at all. People can feel faint and dizzy. And in severe cases, you can actually get confused and even pass out. The most important thing, though, is to just obey that thirst and get the fluid in when you feel like you need it.
Okay, so always have that water ready.
Always.
Because you never know when you're going to start feeling dehydrated. Who is the most susceptible to becoming dehydrated?
So the most susceptible people are going to be the extremes of age in our population, the very young children and the elderly. But a population that really has to pay attention in this environment as well are pregnant women. Obviously, they're drinking for themselves and also for the baby that's inside them. Mm-hmm. There are a lot of patients, though, that are on medications that can increase their susceptibility to being dehydrated, most commonly when they take a medicine known as a diuretic. This is a medicine that actually gets rid of excess fluid. Mm-hmm. So if you can imagine, now you're sweating quite a bit, you're already on a medicine that's getting rid of excess fluid, and that can tip you over to being dehydrated very quickly.
We live in Hawaii, so a lot of us are used to warm weather, 365, and we think dehydration is no big thing, but mm-hmm. it can be a big issue. So when does it become a big medical concern or a medical emergency?
Absolutely. Dehydration becomes the emergency when you can no longer orally hydrate yourself. That is, when you can't take in by mouth everything that your body needs and is wanting. This can happen if you're just too weak to drink fluids. It can happen if dehydration is associated with vomiting, where you can't get the fluid in anymore. Now, with exertional activities in the heat, though, it can also present as a heat-related illness. And now this is a spectrum that starts with something we call heat cramps, which are just when your whole body, all your muscles are cramping at once. If you don't really do anything about it, it can progress to what's known as heat exhaustion. That's cramping with nausea, vomiting, and extreme fatigue. In extreme cases, there's actually something called heat stroke, which is everything I've mentioned, but now with a neurologic abnormality, something like you're so confused, you can't walk straight. Mm-hmm. It can actually be so severe it could lead to seizures or even coma. The most important thing is that if you have any signs of a heat-related illness or you can't orally hydrate yourself, that's when we want you to present immediately to the nearest emergency department for evaluation and treatment.
We've been talking about water a lot. Any other precautions that we can take?
So when you're out there, it's very important that obviously you maintain your hydration during your activity, but also after you're done. People need to realize that they just got to get all the fluids back in them. But when you're out there, if you do have periods of rest, find some time in shade and cool areas. And you got to take advantage of our island breezes and the trade winds to help you with that evaporative cooling effect. On those really stagnant days where mm-hmm. there's no winds,
right.
you might want to have one of those handheld portable fans that can help with that evaporative loss. And your choice of hydration fluid is important. Water is great, mm-hmm. but if you're not taking any salt in, water doesn't really stay in the body where it's supposed to go. So basically, people who make the biggest mistake that they say, hey, I was drinking all day long, well, how did I get dehydrated? Well, you were drinking water, but did you eat anything? So you also need to eat, or there you can take a salt tablet supplement, or the electrolyte-based solutions that are out there that have sugar and electrolytes in it, they can do the job as well.
Things like maybe Gatorade or Powerade, those
Absolutely.
Things? All right, good tips. Thank you so much for being here.
My pleasure.
Now, if you have any more information, you can go to AdventistHealthCastle.org, or you can call the number 263-5400. Again, AdventistHealthCastle.org or 263-5400. Stay cool.
You too.